Hi guys, Ariel with Ariel Paints, and I have a tip for you today about using your black and white at festivals. I have started to use a cake with black and white. This is a Diamond Effects white pot that I had split in half and put DFX black on the other side. The reason I do this is because I like to hold my black and my white when I'm doing details on kids. A lot of times I'll hold it in my hand while I'm kind of holding the child's face or head steady, and then I'll do my line work. So I'm actually dipping in and then going right back to their forehead. And this keeps it nice and handy for me. Even though my kit is right next to me, it's just that much more accessible, and I really, really, really like it. Also, I'm usually working with someone, so I've made one of these for my assistant as well so that she can have her own black and white. Since it's the color we use the most, it just makes sense. Now, I will say I also have a multitude of different blacks and whites in my repotted palette. So I will show you this as well. And I have Wolf and Diamond Effects White. So Wolf White, Wolf Black, Diamond Effects Black, and Diamond Effects White. And then I have a Pearly White. The reason I have so many of these is because they are different paints. I like using Diamond Effects the most. It's personally my favorite paint. I love it for line work. I like Wolf also because it's very, very opaque, very dense, really nice paint. However, I'm usually painting in a very, very humid climate, and it tends to get kind of sticky. I don't particularly like the black for line work. I feel like when I use it for line work, I am dipping into my paint trying to get that creamy consistency more often than I am with the Diamond Effects. So I just prefer it. However, I have this array because I like them all. Now I also use a Pearly White for things like the muzzle of tigers and cats, or any kind of larger coverage of a white area on the face with water activated paint, because it's softer, more ethereal, and you don't get that cakey clown look that you get sometimes by doing that with pure white. And it's easier to blend into those split cakes that you might be using for the main part of a cat or a dog or whatever it is you're doing. So I always have that in my kit as well. But I will say, this has proven to be a lifesaver. I used it at my last festival and it was great. So if you're somebody who likes to hold your black and white or have it in your hand while you're painting and doing that detail work, try it. It's awesome. It kind of looks like a yin yang too, which is kind of fun. Now the other thing that I recommend doing, if you don't do this already, try it. When you're at an event, have a designated white brush and a black brush for your smallest detail brushes, and then your next size up is typically what I do. So like a 2 or a number 1, I will have 1 black, 1 white, and then about a 4 or a 6, same thing, 1 black brush, 1 white brush. Not only does this help me designate that's the white, that's the black brush, I'm never gonna wash those out, I reach for them really quickly, but if for some reason you aren't doing this and you have 1 number 6 in your kit, and every time you're switching from black to white, you're cleaning out and washing that brush out and then going to and loading it up with white, not only are you mucking up your water, but you are wasting a lot of time. And that's a big extreme, going from black to white, two completely different pigments in the color spectrum. So you're wasting a lot of time and spending a lot of time cleaning out brushes. So designate 4 main brushes to black and white. Now, if you do paint with someone a lot and you find it's getting kind of mixed up and they keep taking your black brush and it's not working, then I recommend just painting the handles. So if these 2 brushes are your white brushes, then paint the entire handles with acrylic paint and paint them bright white and say to everybody, hey, the bright white brushes are the white brushes, don't wash them out. Same thing with the black brushes. And that'll help because I paint with someone and every now and then my, you know, detailed black brush for unicorns, which is my go-to, is gone because she's using it for something and I panic because this is my black brush. So that might help, but do try this because it'll save you a ton of time at festivals. So I hope you guys like it. I hope you try using a little pot of black and white at your next festival and let me know how it works for you. Thanks for watching.